Hi everyone, Viktoriya and Oksana here. Let me know if you're watching this. Say hi to us as well. Okay, let's see who's... We'll get started with the video in a second, just to make sure that we're live. Let me check. We want to talk about, in this video, we want to talk about that it's okay to be different. Hi Mia, thanks for joining. Hi Yuri. Hi Yuri. Okay, so if your doctor or your friend does not believe that you can recover from autoimmunity, it is not your job to convince them. So there's a couple of things you can do. So you stay with your doctor and you prove them wrong and actually reverse your illness. And if you think that they are open to new information, you can also tell them, how about you base your opinion on results rather than theories? So it's very easy for people to dismiss something when they have never done it themselves, or they don't have the right information or experience. So you may or may not be able to get through them, through people who don't believe that you can get better. But what gets people through is proof. So you cannot change everyone's mind. Even though some people are really smart, they still have hands over their ears, they walking around with their eyes shut and their mind shut, and we can't help those people. Yeah, so when you get your disease gone, then these people will listen. So you don't have to try to convince everyone, and it's okay to be different. So we work with a lot of doctors as well. And we know a lot of doctors who are very educated, but because they don't have experience in healing people the way that we do it and how we do it, they don't have much to say about how it's done or whether it makes sense or not. And if you want to get better at anything, you have to be okay with standing out. You have to be okay with being different. And you have to be okay with letting people believe what they want to believe. So it's very different to heal yourself from an incurable disease, and we have no problem being different. So it doesn't really bother us. And it took us 10 years doing things that were considered not normal, that were considered different, and it brought us here now helping you recover. So yeah, actually, I don't think many people care about what anyone does. I think when you worried about what people think, you care too much about being different. So if you want a different life from other people, you have to do different things and you have to be okay with standing out. And every person in the United States ends up taking medicine usually by their 40s and 50s. And by the time that they're in the 70s, they're taking 10 or more medications. And 7 years ago, I was shadowing this doctor, and there was a patient who was in and out of hospital for various conditions, including STDs and cervical cancer. And she told me, when I'm her age, I will have these problems as well. And the doctor that was shadowing pulled me aside and he told me it's not true. It's her lifestyle that caused her to have all these health problems. So your lifestyle choices really do determine your future. And to be able to reverse your disease so you can live your life freely is amazing. So you want to be different. And it's not your job to convince other people to do something they don't believe in. And in fact, if you're trying to convince someone who's not ready, you're going to waste your energy and raise your stress level. So besides, many people don't listen to advice from someone they don't consider an expert. Even if you yourself have killed yourself, most likely they will not listen to you. So you need to be okay with being different and being confident doing what you need to do to recover. Yeah, for example, if you're at the party and someone is diabetic, would you make them eat a cake because it's their birthday? And if someone is recovering from alcohol, are you going to force them to have a shot of vodka because it's Christmas or it's their birthday or New Year? So you have to let other people do what they need to do. Like, and you don't have to convince anybody to do something. So if someone is trying to force you to do something, you could always say, you know, I don't need this stuff or I don't drink this stuff right now, but I'm here to celebrate. I'm here to see you and spend time with you. That's something that we tell our clients to say when they feel uncomfortable.
Being different.
And it is epidemic that there are so many people dying from diseases that they should not be dying from. And you got to do more and you got to stand up for your health because no one is going to do it for you. And it's okay to be different and you don't need to convince other people to do what they don't want to do, what they're not ready to do yet. Okay. So, hi Lee, hi Valietta, hi John. So, and you can.
Juan.
Juan. She, it's Juan. So if you can watch a replay of this video, and this video we talked about how it's okay to be different, and it's not your job to convince other people to do something that they're not ready for. So it's different to heal from chronic illness. It's not normal considering the United States, but if you want to have a different life, you have to be okay with doing things differently. And so that's what we're talking about in this video. Hi, Muhammad. Hi, Crystal, Marie. Thanks for joining. Hi, Mom. My mom's here. By the way, my mom's name is Nina. She's always watching the videos. She always puts the emojis. It's funny. Hi, Valietta. Good to see you. How are you? Yeah, so say hi to us so we can also say hi back to you if you're watching this right now. All right, so we're gonna finish up this video. Let me know if you have any questions about that. So we talked about, it's okay to be different and it's okay to stand out. Okay, hope you guys have a great day and we'll talk to you soon.